When it comes to soybean weed control, the market segment that has grown the most in the last few years has been the post-emerge residual control options, especially the group 15s. When I think of group 15s, what I'm thinking of is Warrant, Dual, Zidua, Outlook, those kind of products.
We also think about some other products that we've been using in this market for a number of years as well, like the ALS type products, things like Pursuit, for example, or we look at other products like PPOs. We've been using Flexstar and Cadet for many years too. So there's quite a few different things that are coming together now as combination products as well.
So when we talk about the combinations, the two most popular ones are Warrant Ultra, that's got Warrant Group 15, along with Flexstar, that PPO chemistry, or you could go to FMC's basic version of the same type of thing, where we've got Anthem Max, and that gives you Zidua Group 15 along with Cadet, the other PPO.
Don't get us wrong, we still want to start with that good pre-emerge program down, but adding some more residual in crop can give a pretty nice return on investment. But one of the big keys here is you're going to have to look at what the cost of those programs is.
Fortunately, these products are pretty inexpensive. Whether you're talking Warrant Ultra, Anthem Max, or even just the straight Group 15s, you're gonna spend less than $10 an acre. So it's no big deal. Darren mentioned return on investment. That's what we always have to be focused on. And we're not saying you have to use an early post soybean residual product, but we do want you to get that good pre down. If you have a mess out there, you have lots of weeds, you know more weeds are gonna be coming, you have lots of Roundup resistant weeds, that's when you use this early soybean residual post-emerge.
One thing to keep in mind too is the group 15 portion of these residual herbicides, you're not gonna get any burn down activity on the grass weeds that you're trying to get after or the small seeded broadleaves. However, you may burn the crop just a little bit, especially if you're putting it in a tank mix. We see these combination products heating things up a little bit on the crop, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes you see a little bit of leaf curling, may get a little more sunlight through the canopy to get that white mold held down in check a little bit too. I'm being facetious here. It doesn't really matter if that happens. I'm just worried about the weed control, and we are seeing a big step up in late season weed control.
The last thing that I'll say is, I just really encourage you, if you're gonna do this, do it very early post-emerge. If you wait and let things get big, now you're not gonna have the same performance, because we need some rain on these products to get the residual out of them. So get your pre on before you plant, or certainly before the soybeans emerge, then get these early post products on shortly thereafter.
We do typically see a good return on investment using post-emerge residual products in soybeans. One of the weeds you may be targeting is our weed of the week. Can you identify this week's weed?